Sustainability. Yes, that is entrepreneur, social media and reality. Is the man in the building? Can you put them together for one?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Y-Babs. That's an alias, by the way. My actual name is Yusuf Babatunde. That's my actual name. And I'm sorry for kind of misleading you with Y-Babs. But you can have a call Y-Babs over you see me out there. That's fine by me. That's just my name. I don't really want to talk much about myself because outside so much entrepreneurship skills I think I have. I'm just simply a writer and a poet. Just call me like that. I'm a writer and a poet. I don't want to talk much about myself. The topic I will be speaking on today says social media and reality. The difference. What's the difference between social media and reality?
We all have mistaken the real meaning and the usage of social media in this part of the world. Yes, according to Oxford Dictionary, social media actually means a user. It cannot operate itself. It's a form of e-commerce, electronic communication, where you use either website or applications or whatsoever thing to actually connect with people, social networking and all that. You actually create and share. That's the focal point there for me. You create and share your content. You do what? Create and share your content. How many of us today create and share our own personal content on social media? The other go on Facebook. Oh, I see more friends. Yes, I see this person. Make a harder. That's what we do, chat. That's what mostly do on social media. And there's more to social media than that. Social media is more of a business for you than most of these things we do over here, I mean down here in Nigeria. It's more of a business for you. We all need to create our own content. There's nobody in this life that is useless. We all are very much useful, regardless of the school you attended, regardless of the course you read, regardless of the personal acquisition skill you think you got, regardless of whatsoever, vocational skill you think you've learned. Don't think the next man that hasn't learned anything, that has no education, that has no whatsoever you think, is useless. We all are very much useful. Why do I say we all are useful? We all have what we call a predestined purpose in life. God has actually predestined our destiny for us. He has given individuals their own talents. We all have our talents. We just need to actually seek. We need to actually seek the inner self. We need to seek our inner mind. We need to actually seek ourselves down. We need to actually use, not just the two eyes we're seeing here, our inner eyes, to actually see for ourselves our own personal talents. So you need to realize your own talents. As we all exist in this world, let me kind of dive into religion a bit. God actually gave us a child. Every individual, every one of us, God has given us a child. Be you a Christian or a Muslim, in Islam, they do say that we have angels watching over us, on our shoulders, and we have this child in us, where they write our deeds. That's where they write our deeds. Individual things you do, either good or bad, they write your deeds on the child. So that's the same way it is for everyone of us. Give religion out of this. Normal life, that's the way it should be. We all have our own individual time. The time where they carry, not being my own brother, who they born me with, they carry. So it's so surprising to me when I see people on social media these days get it all wrong. They do all sort of unnecessary or irregular things on social media and they think they're doing the right things. Most people do tell me, like, okay, but you don't listen to WhatsApp. First of all, you know they see me now. Just like it goes for WhatsApp. You add me on page, you add me chat, you add me to this and all that. And I tell them, that's not WhatsApp is for. That's not what WhatsApp is for. I'm sorry, when I have free time, you have something you want to talk to me about, yes, in the chat. Not before me, not be anything. It's not about trying to, you know, on their phone or say, get past or whatever thing. I'm sorry to say, I know we all have this. Like I said, no one is useless. I'm a very busy person, I tell people. Even at times when I'm at home, sitting, and you think I'm not doing anything, I'll still tell you I'm busy. because truly I am busy. When I'm in toilet, I spend 2 hours in toilet. No light. At times I spend 2 hours in toilet. I'm serious about this. And I'm not in the toilet pooping or doing some stupid things in the toilet. I sit in my toilet to meditate. I sit in my toilet to plan my day. I sit in my toilet to actually see my own future. I sit in my toilet to do a lot of things. So when they tell me about, you don't see your WhatsApp, what's happening now? You know the two chats and all that, I tell them no. I'm sorry to say, anytime you make a message you want to from, you drop out from me. If I reply, if I get an reply, but if it's a business thing, at times I intentionally ignore some messages, not because I want to ignore them, but I want to ignore them because I have more important messages to attend to or things I am doing. No focus. No business. So majorly, I want to address something again about the social media thing. People come on social media to actually insult people, talk about people's lives, what people do, to actually compare their lives to that of people. You want to be like Whiskey. You want to be like Video. You want to be like AG and all that. But I tell you this, you can never be like them. It's not a course. You can never be like Whiskey. You can never be like Video. You can never be like AG. You can never be like whatever people or girl you think you see on social media. The only person you can be like is yourself. Social media and reality, the difference. So I'm here to preach to you more about reality than social media. Reality is what we call real life. Reality is what we call real life. So you need to be more concerned about reality than social media happenings. All you need to do right now, like I said, you're looking at your content, no time to waste. Create your content, meet people that actually know about it. If you need a web page designer, a UX designer, a web page developer, graphic designer, anybody you need to actually make your dream come true, you need to go through that person. For the financial part, of your dream, if you have people, uncles, aunties and all that, if you don't have them yet, just try to save yourself, you understand? Make your own, you should have a saving account. Save for whatever thing you're doing, you start things, you start small. Nobody actually started doing in life, let me tell you. When did they actually became the top billionaire? The investors of Amazon today were still borrowing money up and down, were still lending money up and down. The investors were still lending money up and down for people. They have a bit of money, they have a gross amount of money there. That's what they were still doing, to actually build what we now call Amazon today. So that's something about life. You start small. Nobody started big. Warren Buffett did not start big. Bill Gates did not start big. Jeff Bezos did not start big. Nobody started big. Mark Zuckerberg did not start big. He started small. The school he attended is a dropout. The school he actually attended was like one of the smallest schools in America, not one of the top schools he attended, and he's a dropout. Because he lived in his dream, what he was doing. He was an addict who missed, who skipped classes for what he was doing. He would skip classes in the hotel room. His friends would come around, a guy who's not 48. When he makes it, not define you. Then he would show them from where he started from. He started from something, face something, or page, or what's the name of where he started from. Before he went on this Facebook of today. So that's like, you find your own personal core. You don't forget your life, that or that or that. We are all misled on social media today by the things we see on social media. But we want to see the flashy light, the flashy cars. People actually, you know, posting in front of people's houses, snapping and putting on social media, claiming it's there and all that. I tell you today, it's not just about your qualification, it's not about the school you attended, it's not about you being a graduate, it's not about you getting a good job, it's not about you getting married, it's not about you having kids, it's not about you building or buying houses. It's not about you spending money, you know, showing off and all that. It's not about you spilling drinks and all that. There's more to life than all these things we do. There's more to life than all these things we do. That's why I keep saying we should actually find our calling, our own core. We need to find it. Leave social media out of this. Like I said, I was speaking against social media and I don't really like it because social media is very much helpful. But the only problem I have with us, we don't know the use of social media. Social media is not for Facebooking, it's not for text messaging, it's not for chatting and all that. Find your core.